Second question. Is there anybody in the group that's a licensed pilot?
Anybody allowed?
Start over here. Big ones, little ones?
Little
ones, okay, over here.
Private
boat. Private boat? Okay, good enough. Do you fly also? Okay,
anybody in the aviation industry in any way, shape, or form? Engineers,
or
anything like that?
Or just, flight attendants?
No, okay, last question. Did any of you actually get to ride on Concorde? Did you? From where to where?
Around what decade, what year, do you remember what year?
Like 99.
99? Okay, nice. Okay, I'm asking questions like this because poor guy, I like to know if I can lie to you. I won't do that. I can't do that. Not lie to you. Questions I ask you, tell me whether I can. First question sounds like you're just being nice. You know, where you're from. I'm looking for the Brits. I'm looking for the French. The English and the French are the ones who built the plane. I've learned you cannot lie to them about Concorde. You can't lie to them about their plane. Brits go crazy for this thing. They're proud of it. And they have a right to it, right, Bruce? Why this is special, why were you doing it? The fastest jet airliner that ever carried people across the Atlantic Ocean. Flew at speeds of over Mach 2, 1,350 miles an hour, over 2,000 kilometers per hour. It's got a big reputation. People in the industry, pilots. I ask you if there are any engineers. It doesn't matter if you're an engineer or somebody who's putting the bags on the plane. It's got a big reputation. You probably know about it. This is an ad from British Airways, 1980. Sums up the reputation. Who cares enough to make the world happy? The longest trip you've ever been on an airplane. Divide that by two. That's pretty much what Concorde could have done the trip in. That's an exciting idea. I always like to point out that she looks very excited down here. This is good advertising for British Airways. But anybody who has sat on an airplane for 8 hours, well, I get Australians on the tour, 20 hours, 22 hours for them. When you tell them that, you better believe if they don't get excited, they at least get interested and they ask questions like, why isn't it still flying? Why can't we take advantage of this thing? Why isn't it around to get me some car? Well, for your $20, whatever you paid today, I'm going to give you some reasons why it's not still flying. You can simply save money if you want to. There's a lot of things that go into it. We'll discuss a few. We'll also talk about why it could do what it did. Just so you know, I'm not a pilot. I'm not an engineer, any way, shape, or form. I've worked with this plane as a tour guide for about 5 years. I know I've learned a few things about it, so I can talk a little tech, like why it could do what it did. And then we will climb inside. I will let you sit in the seats. We'll be in there for probably 30 minutes. While we're in there, I will give you a little bit of an idea. I'll give you a play-by-play. Take you back to a day that our plane did something pretty special. Because ours is a record holder, that means it did a few things the other Concordes never did, so that means it did a few things no other airplane did. And we'll go back and see if we can't relive one of those days.
There's no gate key here, but you can pull out the last one.